Hello everyone. My name is Marco Arrigoni. I'm a director of marketing with Coherent. I'm responsible for the scientific research market segment. Today we are going to have a brief conversation with Bo Li, who is the winner of the 2020 Bernard Guyot Prize with his research at the Cornell University under Professor Chris Xu on imaging of brain structures. The Guyot Prize is sponsored by Coherent, providing $25,000 to an early career investigator in the area of ultrafast optics and its applications, and is also managed and organized by the OSA Foundation. If you are interested in finding more detail about the prize, you can look on the Coherent or on the OSA Foundation website. So I would like to start by welcoming and introducing Bo Li, and congratulating Bo not only for the Guyot Prize, but also for his recent professorship position at Fudan University. Hello, Bo.
Hello, Marco. Thank you very much. Yes, I did accepted a position as a professor at Fudan University.
Well, many congratulations for that. That's great to know. Bo, can you tell us, can you speak to us about the research that led to you winning the Guyot Prize, please?
Yes, of course. So we invented a femtosecond laser source, the adaptive excitation source, to reduce the power requirement for two and three photon imaging of brain activity in the awake mouse. So in detail, in our risk approach, an initial structure image of the targeted set of neurons is then used as a spatial key to turn the adaptive excitation on and off during subsequent activity scans. In this way, we could image 30x faster while imaging the brain.
Okay, thank you for this explanation. So I would like a follow-up question on that. Can you tell us why speed is important while imaging the brain?
Yeah, so understanding how neural circuits works is important for brain research. We could use imaging methods to record the neuronal activity. For example, if we use a calcium indicator such as G-CAMP, we need at least more than 10 hertz to record the action potential because the duration of one spike of the fluorescence trace is around a second. But well, when we image for voltage indicators such as ASAP, we need at least more than 1,000 hertz because the duration of one fluorescence trace, the one spike, is around a millisecond. So speed is very important for imaging the brain.
Oh, okay. Thank you very much, Bo.
Thank you.
So I understand that this is key because we want to follow the function of the brain in real time. So the same time scale where the neurons actually react.
Yes,
Okay.
exactly.
Okay. I would like to ask you also, did you see interest from other research groups to use your same technique or to develop similar type of setups?
Yes, we did. Fortunately, we know many groups seem to be excited by our adaptive source, in particular, early adopters in neuroscience. My background is laser physics, and I'm always impressed by the neuroscientists working in such a demanding field. So they are typically willing to use any technology innovations to solve their problems, including ours, of course.
Okay, no, thank you, Bo. Actually, I share your comment because I noticed that among our customers, neuroscientist seems to be the one that are always ready to adopt new technology and also do some development in the field of optics. And this brings to my next question is, can you tell us something about your new position at Fudan University?
So my new position is in an Institute for Translational Brain Research at Fudan University. So the institute is quite new, established in 2019. Yet it has already attracted many leading neuroscientists in China, as well as young principal investigators from all over the world. Here, I will both work on the development of optical imaging methods, such as adaptive excitation source, multiphoton microscopy, and also work on pushing the techniques to neuroscience. I'm looking forward to collaborating with some very talented people here, and I hope we will solve some important neuroscience problems together. Here, I need to thank the Bernard J. Collier Prize very much. The funding from it is being used to help me accelerate these efforts.
Okay, thanks for this comment. It looks like Fudan is going to be a very stimulating environment. And you describe a wide range of activity. Are you planning to continue this specific development on the adaptive source, or you're looking at something different?
Yes, I will. So the adaptive excitation source could be used to achieve unprecedented imaging performance for applications of neuroscience. But at the same time, I will also work on the improvement of the microscopy itself. So by putting the new laser and the new microscope together, I think I can do a lot of things. For example, I want to increase the speed of two photon emitting from 30 hertz to 1 kilohertz. Which will enable recording of the voltage signal from the neurons. Also, I will try to increase the penetration depth of 3 photon emitting for much deeper brain area, and also increase the field of view of 2 or 3 photon emitting for high throughput recording of neuronal activity.
Okay, so this seems to match the challenges of neuroscience, which is to go faster, to go deeper, and go wider in the imaging.
Yeah.
Okay, so I would like to close this brief conversation asking if you notice any difference between working as a researcher in the United States and working in China, where you recently moved.
I haven't seen any huge difference when doing research in China versus the United States. Almost all the scientists I know simply enjoy and focus on their research. Perhaps the one slight difference I found is that people are happy to work harder in China. For example, many PhD students and postdoc volunteer for additional research after normal work time.
Wow, that actually can be quite convenient when you have a new professorship position, I would say. Okay, well, I think that with this we can end our conversation today. So I would like to thank you very much and congratulate it for your prize, and also wish you the best in your new position at Fudan University. And thank you very much, Bo.
Thank you very much, Marco.